successful ladies in your own right, what is your recipe for success in life?
Can I go first?
Yeah, go first.
No, it's me.
Oh, me. Oh, right. Okay. I think the first thing is just turn up. Mm-hmm. Do you know what I mean? Like, even when you don't feel like it, just turn up. For me, there are days when I don't feel like going to work. There are days when I don't feel like doing projects that I need to do. There are days when I don't feel like leaving my house. For example, today I didn't feel like leaving my house. Do you know what I mean? But I still turned up. And I feel like that makes the difference. And also, like, we all know everyone says hard work and all that stuff. Mm. But I feel like hard work and also networking is really important. And we met at a networking event, I don't know if you remember.
Yeah, no,
but yeah. Okay. And that's the thing. That day, I didn't know I was gonna meet anyone. I didn't know, like, we would move on and then do this project together. I didn't know that I would, do you see what I mean? So sometimes,
yeah,
networking is massively important. I know it's a drag, I know it's a bore, usually, because every time I get invited to those networking events, I always almost don't show up. But once I get there, I just get my energy levels back up, and I'm like, okay, I'm here now, I just need to face this and do the best that I can. So I guess that's another point, do the best that you can.
Yeah, definitely.
Every day you turn up.
Yeah, definitely. And I agree with you totally, yeah.
You know, I think over the years, for me personally, I think success is a mindset. Like, I just need to tell myself, the recipe for success for me is to just to believe, turn up, like you said, this is what I want to do. I'm going to do it whether I like it or not, whether it's comfortable or not. And then I define whether I'm successful or not. If I've done this, it's not because I'm just, that's it.
Yeah.
You've got to believe in yourself. Yeah. You've got to say, this is what I came here to do. This is who I am. I'm doing it. I'm touching one life. Mm-hmm. I'm touching a million. Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter how many. Mm-hmm. But that is success. I'm enjoying my life. Yeah. I'm happy and I'm getting things done.
Yeah. I agree with you totally. It's the whole thing of, like, you're not measuring yourself by anyone else, anyone's standard. Success for everyone is different. So my definition of success may not necessarily be your definition of success.
Mm-hmm.
And we're all into different things. You're successful at what you do. Mm-hmm. I believe I'm successful at what I do. Do you understand? It's got nothing to do with your bank balance or the number of followers you have, etc. Mm-hmm. The main thing is, like you said, show up, work smart.
Mm-hmm.
You can work hard. Personally, what I find is at the beginning, do not despise the days of small beginnings.
100%.
So when you're gonna start a small a project, whatever project it is, the times when it's going to be tough, and when it's that time, understand that's the season for it. That time it's going to be tough, eventually it gets easier, but be smart about it, you know. And that's the way I look at it. Show up, be there, get out of your comfort zone. You can't be in your comfort zone.
100%.
I mean, I did something in Instagram Live recently, and I talked about the whole thing of having purpose and understanding your purpose. Once you understand your purpose, which definitely cannot be money, I always thought it had to be money, and it's only recently I understood that. And I understand now that I find my joy, my success in the impact and lives I touch. And that's for me, that's successful. It could be one, but I wish I'd started the work earlier and I'd touch one life rather than waiting till I allegedly have this big bank balance that I can then touch 100 lives or 200 lives, you know, so lives, you know. So enjoy the small beginnings, enjoy the season, because each season adds its purpose. And once you understand your purpose,
you're successful.
That's the first part.
And just like running on the back of what you said. And the thing is, also, I think sometimes we forget that success is measured at different stages in your life. So, for example, you got this done on this task, that's success. Celebrate every single step. You know, and because I think sometimes we're obsessed with the bigger plans. Okay, so I want this money in the bank. I want this, I want to have achieved this. Well, guess what? You just did that.
That's a step closer than you've ever been.
So that's success.
Wow.
So I feel like, you know, we don't need to wait until the final bit. Let's start where we are. You're successful at this one. That's one thing.
Yeah.
And then the next thing. Yeah.
I do like the point you made about networking as well, because I feel like so many people do not network enough. And it's something that my husband and I started doing. So we would go to like really posh restaurants and hotels.
I do it too.
We had really posh restaurants and hotels. Initially, it was hard because I'm quite an introverted person, and it may not seem that way. I don't like talking to people I don't like doing small talk very well. I think I've mentioned that.
We've talked about it. Networking thing too.
Yeah. I don't like doing small talk very well. But I've developed success. My confidence. One other thing is seeing myself as successful already. Mm-hmm. If it means that now I feel I'm successful, yeah. I can talk to who I like. Yeah. But yeah, that has that. I think you. When we talk about success in terms of the material, how we, I've got this, I've got that, I think it's really important that you hang around mm-hmm. with successful people. You cannot, you know, a lot of people, in my opinion, or in my experience, especially in the church which we belong to, I feel like we've got quite a big church, so it's quite easy to say, this is my community, and this is our success here. But no, you have to move
outside.
Get a hobby. Horse riding is a good hobby where you meet people with the right type of people. If you don't know, golfing, or as I say, these posh hotels. We went to one posh hotel, just a sidetrack, and we went in there, and we never knew, but it was really posh. And honestly, we bought two drinks, and it cost us about £100.
So whilst you were there having the drink, what happened?
This was the worst thing. That was our first thing. So we spent it. Right. We made the investment.
I love that you see it as an investment, because it is.
It is an investment. Yeah.
But we didn't speak to anyone, because I think it was they sort of set up so it's such a nice atmosphere, and everyone was talking. We didn't want to butt in. But people like conversations. Yeah. You forget that people don't mind talking. If they do mind, they'll let you know.
Yeah.
But most times people actually enjoy meeting new people.
Yeah, definitely. I agree. Yeah.
And also people actually get jobs from networking. People get projects from networking. I spoke to a lady recently, and she said one day she actually went to a networking event. She didn't feel like going. Mm. But one of the ladies she spoke to, who she thought she didn't get along with, actually said, I think there's a role that I want to invite you to my firm for. Yeah. And then she came to the firm. Yeah. Now she's working there. Yeah. She makes a whole lot of money.
Yeah.
And it was random.
Yeah.
First, she left that networking event thinking it wasn't productive. Yeah. And guess what? Yeah. She actually had a benefit from that.
Yeah. Same thing. I went somewhere yesterday, and it was something I was going to cancel, even though I've known about it for a long time.
Usually those ones.
And I was going to cancel. And you know, up till sort of like 12 o'clock, I was dilly-dallying around there. And the person called me, oh, Caroline, so what time are we meeting? I'm thinking, oh, God, all right, if we're still meeting up, all right, then. Eventually, anyway, we went. 3 o'clock, it was... She came to my office and we went together, and coming back, I came out with a property from it.
Wow.
A property.
That's amazing.
Wow.
Proper networking. And it's like, yeah, it's all yours. Decide what you want to do with it. Let me know. It's been sitting there. No one's using it. You're on your own.
Wow.
You know, that's what
a success story. Networking, people. Network your way to the top.